the two major economic perspectives of invisible hand feed the greed or top-down command and control, they're abject failures. They're failures as an economic system, but worse than that, they give us a perspective on humankind that's a lie. It's false. It's not true to what we know scientifically about human beings. And that's why Lynn Ostrom won that Nobel in 2009, as the economists themselves recognize we need a third way, we need a middle path, and that evolution and cooperation might give us a way forward. And so if you look at what we've done with laws, for example, in the United States of America, most corporations are organized under a set of laws that require the boards to only care about profit. That's insanity. It's insanity. They can be sued. They can lose. If they care about anything else, they care about the workers, they can actually literally be sued by stockholders. And you can organize under another set of principles. You can be a B Corp. And when we went through the last downturn, the B Corps did a lot better, because the B Corps can be organized under principles that allow you to care about the workers, that allow you to care about the environment, that allow you legally to care. Okay? That's how crazy this economic system, which has led to legal system, which has led to political systems, which is fundamentally at odds as who we are as human beings. And I would rather see people passing laws that you can't organize as a profit-only corporation. Eliminate it. You look at social media, look at that, very shocking kind of film about what's happened inside Google, et cetera, as they begin to change the algorithms, to give people reflected back only the realities that they prefer. So if you pick any conspiracy theorists, next thing you know, it's raising up in the search engine other conspiracies that you didn't even know existed. What an insanity. That should be illegal. Doesn't anybody understand what you're doing? It would be like saying, okay, we should make it legal to run out of the forests and light all the trees on fire. No, we wouldn't do that, because then the forest burned down. But we're actively allowing companies to create billions by burning the cultural trees down. And they know they're doing it. But they're also driven by the profit motive. And by the way, the boards of directors are saying, yeah, that's great, because that's the only thing we care about. I mean, come on. So what we're going to need to do, this is one reason why I think who we are, a multidimensional, multi-level evolutionary perspective allows us to rethink so many things. If we're the cooperative species, we're the social monkeys. We're not monkeys, but we need to find a way to put that into our schools and our organizations and our politics. And, I've been actively trying to think through and actually be involved with business. I've started and sold multiple businesses. I care about business, but business needs to be put to a social purpose, and underneath that, into this kind of human psychological purpose. Now, the irony is the very CEOs and board of directors, people, etc., they're reading A Compassionate Mind and Get Out of Your Mind Into Your Life. I mean, they are miserable inside these systems. And when you get, for example, when you do, let's say, an act stress thing in business, next thing you know, this has actually happened with a randomized trial in a very, very large and famous bank, with their stock brokers, who are like rock stars of the banks because they bring in so much money and they're so individually important because their customers care about them. And if they leave the bank, the customers go with them. I mean, they're very important people to the bank, these stock brokers. You walk them through some psychological flexibility things around stress and, creating. Next thing you know, they want to have family day at the brokerage and bring their children and to meet and meet the children of the secretary, who, by the way, they didn't even know the children's names because they've never had the conversations. We have created social environments in our workplaces that are designed for poor mental health. We've created these kind of, we've ripped and torn at what it is that we need, what we've evolved to really care about. And so let's be wiser. Let's evolve on purpose. And I think the nose under the tent on that is evidence-based psychotherapy and a self-help movement that came out of it. Why? Because it reaches the hearts of people. I mean, I got an email 3 days ago by somebody who works with a very, very famous politician that anybody would know in a very close way. And it turns out I've been having email conversations with this person for 2 years because I have a little principle. If anybody emails me, I respond. So every person that has OCD on the planet can email me and I freaking respond. You know, I mean, I don't know why. I just always thought it's of importance, you know, somehow that one. And it turns out I go back because I realize, oh my goodness, this person is connected to somebody who can change things internationally. And initially was just writing me about anxious worries and so forth. And we have our hands on the lever of the culture in a really important way that goes far beyond that individual, because that individual is part of a family, a group, a business, etc. And when they learn how to be more open, more caring, more compassionate, more values focused, more mindful, and they see the transformation that it puts in their lives and their children's lives and the relationships and so forth, let's carry that through the next level. Not in an arrogant way. We have to be very careful. We could make mistakes. Don't just turn over the politics to the damn psychologists. But yes, get us in the room. And when you're talking about COVID or you're talking about the economic problem or immigration or something, couldn't somebody say the word psychologist? Couldn't somebody say behavioral science? Why is it only the political scientists and the economists and the technologists and so forth? I mean, my first book was Environmental Problems, Behavioral Solutions. We're never going to solve the problem of the environment if we can't reach human behavior of, you know, many, many millions of individuals. How's that going to happen? It's going to happen out of these very processes. So we're going to have, there's a lot of things that need to happen in our laws and our regulation, our culture and our businesses. And I think we have an important role out of it. And evolution can give you the one theory that gives you the consilience for all hands on deck, in humility, listening, not just speaking. Can we work out in a data-based way how best to evolve as a human species, as a culture, as individuals, families, communities, and groups? How do we best do that and solve these challenges that are in front of us that if we don't solve, threaten even our existence on the planet?